What will happen to the intervertebral disc after undergoing a disc herniation process several years later? A herniated disc is usually considered benign. Usually, the herniated nucleus pulposus will disappear in a year by phagocytosis or an unknown absorption mechanism. But it is not the end. Life is a process of continuous struggle and changes. It is a matter, of course, true in time that the disc is lowered in height. Here, I want to share a follow-up case of a previously herniated disc. She was 34 years old 3 years ago. Sagittal T2 weight IP image shows posterior annular tear with protrusion of nucleus pulposus flowing to inferior direction. There were subchondral high signal intensities of inferior L5 and superior S1 end plates. Dixon water image shows the bright signal intensity of the subchondral end plate of L5 and S1. Fat image shows subchondral high signal intensity in the same area. It means a mixed stage of modic type 1 and type 2. Axial T2 weighted image shows central protrusion of disc at L5-S1. It was the initial simple X-ray. The lateral view shows mild narrowing of disc height of L5-S1 space. 3 years later, she returned for acute low back pain and remained a simple X-ray. It is the lateral view of the lumbar spine. There is a marked narrowing of the intervertebral disc space and subchondral sclerosis of the subchondral end plate. Please compare with the lateral view of the 3-year-old lumbar spine.